Welcome to TalkNorth.com. Thanks to our longtime producer, Brandon Morton. Please download before you listen. If you'd like to advertise with us, you can reach us at TalkNorthPodcast@gmail.com. And please follow us on Twitter at TalkNorthPod. Two promo codes to be aware of. BiteSquad.com, use the promo code TalkNorth to get your first delivery free. And go to SodaStick.com, the great local apparel company. Use the promo code YouBetcha to get free shipping on any sized order.
Okay, in this episode of The Fan Show, Lonnie's back with me, and we talk some Twins, we talk some Wild, we talk about, that's pretty much it in terms of Minnesota pro sports, but then we have a nice debate or a rundown of the debate right now raging, or that has been raging, around the U.S. Women's National Soccer Team's celebration of goals at the FIFA Women's World Cup. So we got a little, you know, we kind of went after it a little bit. So we waded into the heavy topics, but that's okay. It's a good forum for doing that. So thanks for giving it a listen. And of course, this and all the episodes of The Fan Show are brought to you by Tony Hoagland, your State Farm agent in Champlin. Here's more from Tony right now.
Hey, Minnesota sports fans. This is your local State Farm agent, Tony Hoagland. I need you all to ask yourselves this question. If you're in an at-fault car accident and you are sued for $700,000, how much of that $700,000 will my current insurance company pay? If you are unsure or can't answer all $700,000, you need to give us a call. State Farm has been number one in car insurance since World War II and number one in homeowners insurance since 1964. For a no-obligation review of your current policies, call us at 763-421-4900 or check out our website at www.champlininsurance.com.
All right, Brandon, cue the band. Welcome back to the Minnesota Sports Fans Unfiltered show. That's the Minnesota Sports FU show where misery loves company, and the Twins are providing a little misery. I can't even say it with a straight face. They've lost two games in a row, one of which, what are you going to do in the last game? But Twins fans who continue to freak out every time they don't win 10-0 just crack me up. Just settle down, guys. Just take it easy. Life is too damn short, and it's going to be winter again very quickly. So, God, relax. Anyway, this is Nick with Brandon and Lonnie this week. Lonnie, how you doing, bud?
I'm well. How are you, sir?
I'm doing fine, thank you. What's on your dance card for the week?
Well, I'm getting excited to get all kinds of wound up. NHL draft is coming up.
Woo!
And I am highly anticipating getting all kinds of whipped up about players I've never, ever seen play.
Exactly. Can't wait. Honestly, the best part about the draft, given that we don't see these kids, well, where we draft in the NHL draft, we don't see these kids for years, if ever, is the best part about the draft is that then once it's over, we don't have to talk about the draft again for another year.
Agreed.
I've said this before, but I really think there needs to be a disclaimer. Any draft commentary, prospect commentary, there needs to be a disclaimer about the author of this commentary is not a scout, has never been a scout, never will be a scout, and has never seen this kid play with his own eyeballs. I mean, just stop with the ridiculous draft coverage. It's just, ugh. I mean... People who have no business writing about what your team may do and what they need. I mean, you may as well be reading the side of a box, a can of soup. I mean, just ridiculous. What a waste of time. I'm sorry.
Yeah, it is a lot of opinions formed based on other opinions formed.
Yeah, exactly. I stole this commentary from analysis from somebody who actually knows what the hell he's talking about. And I'm going to filter it through my interpretation of what our GM may or may not be wanting for this particular. I mean, like, come on. It's seven removes away from relevant and accuracy. Just stupidness. So we'll talk about the Wild a little bit, but let's talk about Twins for a while. By the way, I know this will. Speaking of what's your phrase, grinding your gears. Did you see Max Scherzer's going to miss his next scheduled start? It looks like. Do you know why?
I just caught that earlier tonight.
Max Scherzer's taking BP. Of course, he does play in the National League, so taking BP. Practicing bunting, and takes one off the beak, breaks his nose, and they're not sure whether he's going to be able to make his next start. What do you think about that? Granted, he's a pitcher.
Yeah, that's just a bad luck freak thing. I mean, I saw the replay. The pitch was kind of up and in, and he put his bat out in front of it and could not have directed the ball more directly straight into his nose.
That just sucks.
Have you ever seen a close-up of Max Scherzer, though?
What, with the two-color eyes?
Yeah, he looks like a husky.
Yeah, he looks like a husky. He kind of is like a husky in a lot of ways. So now his nose and the area around his eyes will probably match that of the irises of his eyes, right?
At least one of them.
Maybe both. I saw you get. Was it you? Somebody got fired up the other night when Georgie Polanco laid down that bunt. And I know you've beefed about this in the past. Should and it was his call, it sounds like, and Rocco is never gonna blast him in public. But what were your thoughts when you saw him square that around?
I am on these airwaves and on Twitter very much on the record as being anti-bunt, but I mean, with the caveat that there are select situations that I would be on board with bunting. Particularly like the bottom of the ninth inning. I like it a lot better as a home team, but definitely, you know, bottom of the ninth inning, if you need one run and one run will win you the game, there are situations where I'm not opposed to bunting.
Mm-hmm.
But it's all situational. And I hate the American League's leading hitter having anything in his head other than this guy throws me a pitch, I'm going to blast it somewhere. It's just silly to me to bunt in that situation. And it, you know, I don't, you know me, Nick, I'm not a big numbers guy or a big stats or analytics guy, but the run scored probability, whatever they call it,
I don't know,
it's, I mean, there's mathematical facts that bunting for the most part is just not a good play. And it also, I mean, to me, the biggest thing, especially like with Polanco bunting, American League's top hitter. And yes, he was going for a hit. I understand that. But even so, you're just essentially handing the other team an out. I mean, you go from having three chances of getting a hit to score a run.
Yeah.
I don't like it. And, you know, obviously it's easier to get our pitchforks out, you know, when the end result doesn't work. Right. But if I remember correctly, Polanco did the same thing in a game last week. I don't know if it was against Seattle or Kansas City, but same thing. And I don't know, kind of wished the team would talk to him, or if they indeed don't want him bunting. And I don't know, maybe they do.
I mean,
you know,
was he bored of hitting doubles?
Right. And, you know, and when you do go with the sack bunt, your odds of scoring more than one run go way down.
Yeah.
So, well, I didn't like it.
Well, okay, so I started off the Twins part by saying that the people who nitpick every little tiny loss is is annoying to me. But and this is exactly what we're doing. But yeah, no, point well taken. It's definitely easier to slam it when it doesn't work. But I don't know. I kind of like to see him swing away, personally. But look, I mean, tonight notwithstanding, and we're recording here on Monday evening. Tonight notwithstanding, they haven't lost three straight yet this year. Knock wood. So it's the overall, the 30,000 foot viewpoint is that it's extremely difficult to be sitting here being frustrated about anything this team is doing overall at this point.
But you know what's cool as we record here on Tuesday night? I mean, it's cool that we're sitting here on June 18th.
Is it Tuesday? It is Tuesday.
It's so cool that we're all up in arms about one play in a Twins game on June 17th. That's awesome.
And you're absolutely right. It is Tuesday. I don't know where the hell my head is, but we are recording on Tuesday. That's awesome that I got that confused. But no kidding. And you know, you mentioned stats. Now that, you know, we don't want to go too deep into the stat hole. But the other thing that I think has become a sort of a funny, amusing sideshow is all the hand wringing and gnashing of teeth about the Twins pitching, which, okay, so they don't have a perfect bullpen. They don't have, you know, the Astros or starting pitching. They don't have maybe Tampa Bay starting pitching, you know, whatever. But as I look at the stats on MLB.com today, looking at the entire league, the Twins have the 7th best whip against, with a 1.25 whip. So other teams have a 1.25 whip against the Twins. The pitchers have given up that. It's the 7th best number in the league. LA, Houston, Tampa, Cleveland, Cincinnati, New York Yankees, Minnesota Twins. Is it just too Pollyanna to be looking at this from that wide of an angle and say, what are we really worried about or not?
Well, I think their offense has been so crazy good that it's really overshadowed how good the starting pitching has been.
Mm-hmm. Well, I'm comfortable with that. I don't know. This team is so much fun to watch.
Yeah, and, as much of a lightning rod as the bullpen has been, you know, it's like, I mean, if you think about kind of the storylines from this team this year, one, it's the offense, obviously, and two, probably should be the starting pitching being good, and it almost seems like the undercurrent is that the bullpen is bad.
Right.
So, I don't know. I mean, it's impossible to, you know, have one of the best records in baseball without getting good pitching. I mean, that's just impossible.
Yeah. Yeah. No, that's well said. I don't know. I'm not the most in-depth baseball guy. It just seems to me that they can't have been, to your point, the pitching staff overall can't have been that bad given what the record is. So, I don't know what we're, you know, it can always be better. I mean, there's always, you know, whatever. But now, that being said, you know, what names of starters or whatever relievers are you particularly interested with as you hear them percolating around the rumor mill? I mean, are you chubbed about Bumgarner?
On one hand, yes, but that's because of whenever it was that he single-handedly carried San Francisco to the World Series.
Yeah.
I mean, it's hard to get that out of your head. And one of the things that I saw on Twitter, and I forget who it was from, it was from one of the Twins Daily guys, but it was something along the lines of, okay, this isn't, you know, whatever year, what year did San Francisco win that World Series?
Was it, I have no idea,
15 or 14, whatever it was. The gist of the point was, okay, the Twins we're in the running for Kimbrel and Bumgarner, but keep in mind it's not 2014